Hello, this is Bern, and if you're feeling overwhelmed, confused, burnt out, and tired at the process of dating, well, you are in luck, because on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you five specific stages of dating and why it really matters which ones you consciously step into. Stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetobe.com. Today's another edition of Get the Love You Crave. And as I mentioned earlier, if you're feeling overwhelmed and tired, chances are, at the process of dating, you're not consciously stepping into this process in a way that gets you what you want. So I'm gonna make a few assumptions right now. First assumption I'm gonna make, if you're watching my videos, is that you want a long-term relationship versus a summer fling. If you want a summer fling, not the guy for you, watch somebody else's videos. If you want a long-term relationship, you're in the right space. Second assumption is you want a monogamous long-term relationship versus a polyamorous long-term relationship. Nothing against them, it's just like most likely than not, if you're watching my videos, you want something that's monogamous and long-term. Now, those two assumptions aside, if that's what you're looking for, then when you start dating, there's different ways of dating that will either push you away from that or put you in the trajectory where that's a possibility. There's no givens, there's no guarantees in life, but you can pretty much bet that if you date a certain way, you're not gonna get what you want. So the first stage of dating that a lot of people go into is non-exclusive, unconscious dating. So what does that mean? That means that you, and there's nothing wrong with dating non-exclusively, it's just that if you have those two goals in mind, long-term relationship and monogamous, and you're dating unconsciously, meaning you have no idea what the dude wants, he has no freaking idea what you want, and you're just building momentum and excitement, then you're potentially wasting your life away in that moment. Why? Because it's very likely that he just wants a short-term thing and you want a long-term thing. It's likely that he just wants to have sex and you want something beyond sex. So if you don't take the time or if you don't have the courage to ask the right questions, you're gonna be unconsciously dating unexclusively. Second step within dating unexclusively would be where you're consciously dating unexclusively. That means that you are dating someone, he's not your boyfriend, you are dating more than one guy, he's dating more than one woman, but you're only dating those guys who have the same outcome in theory that you have, who have the same vision for what you want. In other words, they reside in the same universe. I've seen a lot of women who connect with guys who are in a different planet or a different galaxy, and they just get hurt unnecessarily. So again, at the beginning of dating, you're not dating exclusively, which is great, but you are dating someone who you know wants in theory or in principle the same things that you want, so that you're really just exploring things with guys where you have a shot of getting what you want. Third stage of dating, which is probably the worst of both worlds, is where you're non-exclusively dating a guy that you're being exclusive with. That sounds confusing, right? If it sounds confusing, it's because it is. Here's exactly what it means. It means that the guy is dating a bunch of women, a few women, and you're only dating him. And you don't want to take the time or the effort or put yourself out there because you feel, well, he's the one. He's going to show up the right way. So in essence, you're putting all your eggs in one basket, who's not putting all his eggs in yours. So metaphorically speaking, that means that you have a very big chance of this not working out. Am I saying that it never works out that way? Of course not. You have the story of Uncle Bob and Aunt Lula, and they met each other, and the first time they saw each other, he was dating somebody else, but she just stuck by him and they were married for 75,000 years. That happens, but the vast majority of times where you connect with a guy who's dating lots of women and that's your only option, you're gonna show up way more needy, and with reason, right? Because he's your only option, and you're going to be able to see less objectively. Why? Because you need to make this work, because that's all that you have in front of you. It's your only option. So again, stage of dating that I absolutely don't recommend, but a lot of women, a lot of guys fall for this type of dating, and I don't recommend it. Next step would be where you're exclusively dating someone unconsciously. What does that mean? That means you've gone through the stage of perhaps of the non-exclusive dating, or you jumped right into exclusive dating, but you still have no idea what the guy wants, if he's compatible with you, he hasn't stood by the test of time in terms of showing up with courage, presence for more than a few encounters. Same thing him for you. You're unknown to him, right? So what does that mean? That means that if you are dating someone exclusively, you're both of you are putting yourself in a situation where you're not seeing anyone else, but you don't know what you're getting into, the likelihood for nuclear explosion is gigantic. Why? Because you have a lot of expectations for someone that is your boyfriend, or he has a lot of expectations for his girlfriend, and if you don't necessarily match, if you have different values, if you have conflicting values, more than you need to, then it's going to be a painful, painful experience. Next step up would be where you're consciously dating someone exclusively. Now, to get to this stage, you have to consciously date someone non-exclusively in my book, right? Again, I know that in history, not everybody does it this way. This is my recommendation based on years of helping women find the exact love that they want. So you go through the non-exclusive dating phase, and then you connect to someone, and they stand the test of time. You see them in good times and bad times. They show up consistently. They pursue you the right way. You show up in a way where you feel the chemistry. So there's chemistry, there's compatibility, and there's friendship as a foundation for the relationship. What a concept. There's a deep friendship that starts to get created. When that's in place and you know that he has the same vision that you have for family, for long-term relationship, for marriage, for living situation, for lifestyle, if those things match and you enter a relationship, it doesn't mean that it's going to succeed. It just means that it has significantly more chances of succeeding. So I hope that you understand that these five stages are fluid and that it's not right or wrong to go into any of them. You will, however, have a lot more chances to get what you want if you step into the ones that most align to that vision. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful, my dear. If it is, I'm going to ask you to do three things. Number one, click like on my video or thumbs up. And number two, subscribe to my channel. And as you subscribe, you can even hit the little bell so that you get notified every time a new video comes out. Third step is on the first line of the description of this video, you'll find a link that allows you to sign up to a free masterclass that I created for you, totally free, and allows you to understand how to step into this kind of relationship with more grace, less pain, and more speed. Now, if you say, well, Bern, I don't want more videos, I want help. If that's what you're looking for, then there's another link there where if you want my direct help and you want to find if we're fit to work together, click on that link, fill out an application, and we'll connect. And if we end up being fit to work together, we'll do this. I'll give you some hand-holding so you don't have to reinvent the wheel and have to go through more pain than necessary. Regardless of what you choose to do, I encourage you to live a full and conscious life, and I thank you for allowing me into your heart, into your space, and so happy to be able to connect with you. Mwah.